So, if you've got as far as this particular video, I expect that you have also taken the time to watch many of those that preceded it and in the process have learned something about the finite element method. You may also have tried the quizzes and hopefully some of the programming assignments as well. If you've done a good proportion of all of those, you are actually pretty well prepared to go on and do other things with the finite element method and also branch out to maybe learning about other topics which could then use the finite element method. Recognizing, of course, that what we've done so far is essentially meant to be an introduction at about the graduate level in any university. What I'd like to do with this last lecture is point you to some resources out there, some of which you may already have known, and maybe you know about all of these resources, but I'll just point you to some of them as things that you could go on to do having done all this work to learn the finite element method. So I'll start with this slide and this information in front of me. You see, I've talked about telling you a little bit about open source finite element codes, and also about some related course material that's out there. As far as the open source finite element methods are concerned, you see these two links in front of you. The first is for DEAL 2, which of course many of you have probably tried out already, maybe for the assignments or maybe even on your own. So, and the other is for a different collection of softwares, which I will also tell you about. So here we are at the DEAL 2 website, and like I said, many of you may already have seen it and tested things out on it before. DEAL 2 is essentially a collection of, as it says, open source code and libraries, which with the background you have gathered, will allow you to go on and gradually build up more and more of your own repertoire in using finite element methods. You can go to this website yourself and browse around it, but let me tell you how you could very quickly start to be even more effective than you have been so far. If you click here on Dev, you see the drop down list and you go to Tutorials. You come to this page, which actually sets you up to look at a number of examples with theory, the mathematics, and even code that will allow you to gradually go to more and more problems. There are a number of ways in which you can look at it, and the way I like best is to click on the list here, and you see there's an extensive list of examples of problems solved with the finite element method running all the way up to 50 plus problems. So you could start out with any of these. Maybe you can even dive in if you think you've already accumulated some expertise and can afford to go on. So this is something that I would really encourage you to consider. And of course, you have been using DEAL 2 in a somewhat reduced framework as we were teaching you this introduction to finite element methods. Let's go back then and look at the other example of a software that I also have up for you, the Phoenix project. So we click there and it takes you to that website. The Phoenix project is also a collection of free softwares, as you see right here. And they explain what they mean by free software and their philosophy and so forth. In this case, you could go down and go along and look at applications. You see there's an extensive list here of different types of applications that you could use from this collection. If you scroll down, you see some things that you will begin to recognize. You see there is a solid mechanics library. There's something here for time integration, which you also know a little bit about. Fokker-Planck is another kind of equation. There's micromagnetics and so on, right? There's also software there about going massively parallel and really many things. And the nice thing about DEAL 2 and Phoenix is the fact that they are open source, they're free, and they're also actually very advanced in terms of combining computational science with modern computer science. So I'd really encourage you to consider these two sites more closely. So let's go back then to my slide here. So those are two of the open source softwares that I would really encourage you to consider. There are others out there, of course, and by no means am I saying that the others should not be considered. These are things that we use in our research group. Moving on then to courses. This course that you have been taking, the Finite Element Method for Problems in Physics, is going to continue in an on-demand format after it ends with this first iteration. And what that means is that it will be available for you to start working with at any time that you like. You can start as you like and finish within a certain amount of time after that. You don't need to wait for a particular time when the course is going to be offered to start. These lectures are also available on YouTube. And in order to get to that, let me do something slightly different. What I've brought you to is a page on Open Michigan, as it says, but let me show you how to get there. Well, you can see how to get there. You just go to open.umich.edu, and that will bring you to a landing page where the University of Michigan has provided a whole host of open educational resources. Here, if you then go to the search bar and you type in introduction to finite element methods. I'd look for it earlier. Okay, you do a search. It shows you where the material is available. You click on materials there and you see some of the lectures that you're already familiar with. If you click on the YouTube icon there, it will bring you to the whole series of lectures that you've been using on YouTube, right? So these lectures are already there. They actually were there even before our MOOC began, and I know that some of you had discovered these lectures. Okay, so this resource is available. Also, with Open Michigan, we have provided a different series of lectures. And this is a series called Lectures on Continuum Physics. Okay, we search for that, and there we go. No, Lectures on Continuum Physics, there we go. All right, so this is another series that we had recorded and provided also about the same time that the finite element lectures were provided. You click on materials, and again, you see all kinds of resources there. You see the video lectures. There are also assignments, which are available as PDFs. If you click on the YouTube link, likewise, you go to the series on YouTube. Okay? Now, this series of lectures is also going to be shortly provided on a MOOC platform. Okay? As we say here at the bottom of the slide. And this launch of Lectures in Continuum Physics as a MOOC is expected to happen sometime during 2016. We're not certain exactly when, and this really depends upon how quickly we get all the pieces together. But the video lectures are already available. It's just packaging it as a MOOC that is going to take a little more time. So that's it, really. I wanted to provide a brief indication of where you could go from these lectures that you've been following. And of course, there are many, many other resources already available on the web, and we would encourage you to try as many of them as possible. That's it for now, and stay tuned. We will be back either with more on finite elements or definitely pretty soon more on continuum physics.